Namaskara. My name is Dr.Harihara Murthy. I'm a practicing ENT surgeon in Bangalore for more than 3 decades now. Functional endoscopic sinus surgery is a very descriptive name for a surgery. What we do is the surgery on the sinuses to restore the function, and we use it with the aid of an endoscope. So FESS or functional endoscopic sinus surgery is done to restore the normal functions of the sinuses. Sinuses are basically the air-filled cavities outside the nose, above, behind, and between the eyes. So these air-filled cavities around the nasal cavity have multiple functions that we know of. One of them is that because they are having air inside the bone, they reduce the weight of the skull. The second thing is, because there is air there, in the case of an injury, they cause injury not to transfer entirely into the brain, which is a lot more sensitive. These act as crumple zones. The third more important thing is that these sinuses have an air quality with a high antiseptic nature. The composition of the air in the sinuses is different from the air that you breathe. Though that is the source of the air in the sinuses, the quality of the air in the sinuses is an antiseptic nature. This prevents infections going lower down. The portal of entry of infections can be the nose or the mouth. So the first line of defense is happening at the level of the sinuses. So if a person has got some reason for which the air in the sinuses are not there, they've been sucked out, or they are having some other material inside, maybe fluids, maybe pus, maybe growth like a polyp inside, the function of the sinus is obviated, right? As a result of which you have problems starting. So these problems have to be corrected. So infection in the sinus, or for that matter, polyps in the sinuses, have to be relieved by way of doing surgery to relieve the obstructive material there. And after doing that, what we are doing is opening up the sinuses so that, one, they can be cleaned out repetitively by the patient. Secondly, we are restoring the air quality in the sinuses. And three, you're making the patient breathe normally through the nose. Breathing has to be an effortless, unconscious process. If you are taking effort to breathe from the nose, or you're aware of breathing from the nose, something is wrong. So we need to make sure that process of effortless breathing, unconscious breathing, is restored. So that is what the surgery does. The surgery is a fairly delicate surgery. Why? Because we are dealing with an area which is below the brain, between the eyes, and just above the jaw. So it's a very delicate area. Surrounding the eyes, you have the sinuses. So we have got very close proximity to the eyeball and the nerves of the eye. So it requires one to be quite well trained before venturing out in this particular process. The treatment of the sinus surgery, the FESS that we do, doesn't end with the surgery. The post-operative management, making sure the patient takes good care of the sinuses by regular toileting, makes a very big difference to the outcome of the surgery. So one has to be prepared for participating in the treatment plan, which requires the home-based management as well. So a sinus surgery doesn't end at the operating room or the hospital. One has to continue doing the cleaning and cleansing of the nose and the sinuses as advised, and religiously do it to get the best results. Having said that, if a person has got polyps in the nose, the surgery is the first part of the surgery plan, and after that one has to get an allergy profiling done so we know what the person is allergic to, as a result of which we can cause a treatment plan which also includes desensitization of the allergies, and then we can expect a much better result.